What are the main symptoms of post-polio conditions? Do all those exposed to polio get the same symptoms? Post-polio conditions were first identified and described in the 1980s to the year 2000. Since then, research in this area has become much more specific. There are six symptoms in the cluster related to polio exposure. Each person experiences symptoms differently. They do not always have all of the six symptoms, and the worst symptoms may be any of the six in the cluster. These six symptoms make up the cluster associated with exposure to polio. The main three symptoms, fatigue, weakness, and pain, sometimes appear to be interrelated. One getting worse can make the others feel worse, and improving one can help the others feel improved. Let's go through each of these one at a time. Fatigue is the most pervasive symptom. This means it is a symptom seen and reported widely in the population. Fatigue has a variable effect on the function and quality of life of those with post-polio conditions. We almost expect to hear about it when talking to them about what they can and they can't do. There are many different sources of fatigue for these people. Their fatigue is complex. A team of clinicians may be needed to help the person manage it. The fatigue is experienced in two different ways, separately or both at once. The first is central or general fatigue. It is a flu-like exhaustion that comes on towards the end of the day and which won't easily go away. The brain has been working hard to perform usual tasks and feels drained. It can affect the person's concentration and their ability to participate when fatigue is severe. The second is peripheral or muscular fatigue. Think of this as exertion fatigue in the muscles. This could be in just one muscle group or limb, or from the whole body being at work. The limb or body gets tired or feels heavy, and so it can't continue to physically exert. This signals that physical rest is needed. Weakness on paralysis is a symptom of concern for those who experience polio. It limits their ability to perform strenuous or repetitive tasks and can put them at risk for falling. The weakness is usually asymmetrical and can occur in what had long been their strongest limbs. Remember that a person exposed to polio may have lived for decades without knowing they had subclinical paralysis in their muscles. The weakness progresses due to neuromuscular qualities changing, not because of simply getting old or from using muscles in their day-to-day use. Exercise is often beneficial for these people when prescribed, supervised, and monitored by post-polio-informed exercise clinicians. Clinicians should document using the terms paralysis, paralysis-related, or permanent weakness. Just writing weakness incorrectly suggests that polio-affected areas of weakness can be returned to a non-polio strength. Complex pain is another common symptom that is quite variable and affects the participation of those who are exposed to polio. Usually, the pain is widespread across body areas, averages a moderate intensity of a, say, 4 to 5 on a 0 to 10 scale, and has been experienced for a few decades. Nociceptive pain, which is the body tissue signaling problems from strain, poor quality movement or damage, is the most common type experienced. This is followed by post-polio pain, which is a muscular pain felt as cramping, aching or burning when or after muscles are used. Finally, a small portion of these people have neuropathic pain. This is where nerves are sending disrupted or mixed signals to the brain. While pain medications, pain-relieving treatments, and activity and posture changes can help reduce pain, it is heat modalities and avoiding heat loss that many find most useful for pain relief. Sleep disturbance is a symptom that also has many sources, like the ones listed here. These can cause the person to wake more frequently, and it may then be difficult for them to get back to sleep. Sleep disturbance can lead to a person not being refreshed from sleep, which can make fatigue carry over into the following day. Swallowing and breathing difficulty, and sometimes voice problems, can also be experienced by those who had polio. These symptoms should be carefully observed and asked about. Some people report these symptoms are noticed or get worse towards the end of the day. Remember, swallowing, breathing, and speaking are controlled by smaller muscles, which can have exertion fatigue, just like big limb muscles do. Breathing difficulty is usually connected with iron lung use during someone's acute polio, but not always. Although choking on food is rare, some people do report changing their eating habits, often later in the day, to avoid the risk of choking. Hypoventilation, not getting air in and out of the lungs at rest or during activity, is the main problem for breathing. This is related to diaphragm and trunk muscle weakness and damage to the bulbar area of the brain. Losing a voice is rare, but where post-polio is the reason, voice loss can last for up to a few weeks or longer. For those who talk a lot in their occupations or social roles, this can interfere with their participation. Cold intolerance is a symptom related to losing body heat and often results in the person having trouble getting warm again. It can take them hours to warm up. Being cold can make fatigue, pain, and weakness symptoms worse for some people. Losing body heat for them is like having a house that allows winter drafts to enter. Staying warm takes some effort. Not getting cold is the primary strategy for managing the symptom, but this can be harder than it sounds and can take a lot of planning. What can you do now that you know about this symptom cluster? By knowing about these symptoms and how they can present in someone exposed to polio, you can better understand how their activity and participation is affected. This is important for partners, family members, friends, and clinicians to know. We have a memory game for you to play to help you remember these symptoms and the risks faced by these people. Just follow the link. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. By understanding post-polio topics, you are helping to improve health outcomes. Visit Polio Australia's website for further information and to download resources.